Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast 3D printing tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, it is time for an update on my Geeetech A10T. So the first thing you need to know is this has virtual extruders, and this needs to be set up in the Manage Printers. When we go to Manage Printers, I'm going to choose the A10T, and I'm going to do Machine Settings. Now, so you can see this better, I'm going to stretch it out. Of course, there is a full video where we actually did this, but I'm just giving you an update today. If you check up here in the corner, you'll find those videos and the initial setup videos. So down here in the start code, we have got virtual extruders that have been set up. If you look in the properties of this video, you'll find a link to a Google Doc that has all these codes. Now I've got my printer loaded with blue, yellow, and red. If you look at these numbers right here, you can see that this has 100% of the blue, this one has 100% of the yellow, and then finally the third one has the 100% of the red. When we get to the virtual ones, notice it's labeled as T3, but it's going to be my fourth extruder, so it'll be right up here. I have chosen 20% blue, 80% red to make a purple, so you can see here it's 0.2, 0.8 with 0 of the yellow. You'll notice right here the semicolon, these are just comments. I created this little format so I could keep track of which was which and just make sure you always know that it's above that last M164 command that the virtual extruder is created. I'm going to close that right now, and I'm going to close that. So friends, let's bring in a part. I've got this item called frog rings. These are cute little frog rings that I print and leave on Mount Pisgah. So when they first came in, they were set for extruder one, which would be blue, but I want green frog rings, and I'm going to do that with number 5. Now to get this all set up, I had to go to Manage Materials. I'm going to just do that from right here when I click down at the bottom. Bingo, I can bring up all the materials. Now I'm going to start with generic PLA blue. If we check on the print settings, you can see it prints at 200. I do not know exactly why it works like this, but I can print number 1 at 200, and then the rest all need to be at 230 for it to print the way I want. So you can see I've got generic PLA blue. It is set at the 200. And then also if we go down here, I have created a second section called Custom PLA for all these other ones. Now if I click on this, you can see I labeled this V4, which is for virtual 4. Here is my print setting of 230, 60, and so on and so forth. And it's going to be the purple that is used right there. You can label these all here, you can pick your colors right there, and that way this shows up the way it works on the printer. Once I had that completed, I clicked over here and I duplicated it and I made the next one moving on down. I made virtual 5, virtual 6, virtual 7, and virtual 8, and then got those colors to match up for what they actually did on the 3D printer. And then as I tinkered with these numbers, I adjusted them to get them the way I wanted. Now you will notice I don't have these 100% perfect, so this vert 6 really does a cool orange, so I'm going to fix that right now. It's similar to that orange right there. And then I also want to change the word out here to orange. And as you tinker, you can keep making those better and better. All right, so that's how you make and duplicate those. I'm going to close that window for now, and let's connect the printer via USB. Bingo, that is now activated the print via USB. Now we've got our parts set and we've got the printer connected. If you want to see my settings, I always do 0.3 layers. We've got 1.2 for the walls, 0.8 for the top and bottom thickness. I'm going to make the infill 20%. And then notice down here, it does not have the correct material. Let's make sure that we're switching to number 5. We do want to be printing with that one right there. So bingo, now it shows the 230. And then also when we go down, I'm using a speed of 60, retraction is on. I want skirt, but I want extruder 5 to be that skirt. I also want you to know that I use 6 lines and a skirt distance of 10, and I found that purges the prior color pretty darn well. Friends, of course, when it's done slicing, we can send it to the 3D printer. Alrighty friends, so here are our cool little rings. You can see those settings are really heavy on the blue, and that's why I also printed it with number 7, and that one I have more heavy on the yellow, and that green is a lot better. This is one of those things that you're going to adjust though, depending on what green you want and the color of your original filament. So friends, there we are, our adorable frog rings using the different settings. Also, I did want to highlight, I tested the colors as I was building them with this sweet little centimeter cube. You can find that on my website. And let me show you this tutorial for how I made these sweet frog rings. Notice there is the cool hole where we add filament to make those eyes really pop. Friends, this is that adorable Tinkercad frog ring. It was created by a student. The initial design, we had one exact size, and then later I made these adjustable ones so that way they could fit more users. Of course, if you're interested in this project, there will be a link to the tutorial up here in the corner. Friends, as I wrap up, I hope you enjoyed the project. I do want to let you know that I'm using Cura 5.4. Of course, friends, don't forget you can check the corner for all the other videos that I mentioned in this. And if you come up with combinations that you like for your virtual extruders, I'd love to hear about them in the comments. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.